Hey, what's up guys? Jeremy here. Three-axis Cartesian robots come in a wide variety of shape and sizes. A good chunk of them are even custom-made for specific projects. To make sure you can use your specific HBot, RoboDK lets you create your own custom Cartesian robot in just a few simple steps. Let's go through those together. The first step to create a 3-linear axis robot is to import a 3D model. Here I have a rail provided by Lucas Robotics. I will drag and drop the step file to load it in my station. Here I'm using a step file, but IGES or STL would also have work. Okay, perfect, now the 3D model is loaded. So I can open the mechanism builder. So utilities and model mechanism or robot. The default option should be the one to create a linear rail, but in this case, we want the 3-linear axis. Here you have all the indications and steps you need to follow. If you look at the image, it shows you how the axis 1, axis 2, axis 3, and carriage should be positioned, and how it will move with respect to the base reference frame, so FB. Frame base will be positioned at the 0, 0, 0 of the Cartesian robot. We will be able to add a name to our mechanism here, and here we'll be able to select our base frame. I'll talk more on that in a few minutes. And finally, I can add the 3D model of the rail here, the motion directions here, and the limits of the joints here. For the 3D model, there are 4 drop-down menus. This means we need 4 geometries or 4 objects here. Unfortunately, the 3D model we have is grouped in one piece. That's not really an issue, as we can split it inside RoboDK, but I will fast forward the part where I retrieve the 3D model colors and split it into 4 pieces, as I already did a tutorial on that subject in the past. So feel free to watch it if you need that kind of information. Okay, let's do that together. Now that we have one object called axis 1, one object called axis 2, one object called axis 3, and one object called carriage, we are ready to go. Let's reopen the rail builder, so utilities, model mechanism or robot. Let's name the mechanism HBot. Okay. Now we need to position our base frame. The exact position of your rail base will vary according to your specific setup. In this case, I'll go for a normal or more generic approach, if I can say. I will consider that my base frame should be at the zero position of the rail. I will go ahead and create a reference frame exactly there. So I'll create one and name it frame base. Now I need to modify the position of the frame. So let's open the frame panel by double clicking on it. Okay. We need to measure the position of the center of the surface here, so where the robot will be attached. So I need this position with respect to the station origin. The station origin is right here. So let's open the measurement tool. In this case, as the surface is complex, we can't simply use the detect plane option. If we do, it won't give us the center point here. It will give us a point somewhere here. So let's go for a little pro tip. Follow me here. I will use the snap on midpoint and edges. I will select this edge here. That will give me the center point. Then I will do the same with this edge here. So if I select this center point here, it will give me the distance between these two lines. So just like that, it's not very useful, but you can now use this create geometry feature. That will create a line between these two points. Now that we have that line, I can clear selection and reuse the snap on midpoint or edges to measure the center point of that newly created line. And that becomes the center of our surface. Now that I have the distance between the origin and the center here, I can press to copy these values and paste them as the frame position. So just like that, the frame position now matches with the reference image. Now we need to make sure that the orientations are the same. For that to happen, I need to rotate counterclockwise 90 degrees around X. Perfect. Now everything should match. We can select our frame base here and the real 3D models here. So just select each section one by one. If the position of the reference frame you used isn't the 0, 0, 0, XYZ of the setup, then you need to enter the distance as D1, D2, and D3. Now I can enter the length of the rails, or in fact the travel of the carriage, if I can say. So here it's 7,750 millimeters for the axis one travel. So I will enter minimum 0 and maximum 7,750. Okay. I can press update to create the robot. RoboDK will automatically create a duplicate of the reference 3D model you imported so that you can reuse them in the future if you ever need to. But for now, I'll just hide them all. Just like that. Okay, I can move along axis 1 and everything seems fine. For the second axis, the travel is 5,000 millimeters. So let's enter that from 0 to 5,000. We can then update to test this second axis. If for some reasons the axis does not move in the direction you expect, you can always revert the direction by checking this box here. So let's test this one real quick. Okay, that makes sense. For the third axis, it really depends on your needs. If you were to simply enter 0 and 2000 millimeters here, so the length of this section here is 2000 millimeters, obviously. So if you were to simply use these values and press update, this way the robot will start from 0 and will go down 2000 millimeters. That's potentially what you want. But on the contrary, if you prefer having the 0 at the lowest point and 2000 at the highest point, you can simply enter minus 2000 for D3 and 2000 for the build joints. Now I can test my HBot. Okay, make sure it moves in the right direction. Make sure the limits are good. And obviously we need to do that for the three axes. Okay, second axis works fine. Third axis works just fine. Okay, if I'm fine with the result, I can press OK on the model mechanism window. And just like that, in a few minutes, you can create any Cartesian robot you want. You can then save it as a .robot file and load it back in any other RoboDK station in the future. So simply right-click the mechanism and save as. Okay, that's pretty much everything for today's video. I hope you liked it. If you did, please subscribe to our channel. This way you won't miss any new tips or walkthroughs. If you have any technical questions, you should definitely visit our online forum. Our team will be happy to interact with you. And in any case, have a great day, guys.